Check out this bad review.
Anyone can write a review online, Mom. When I want to read honest reviews, I go to BBB.org. Their reviews and complaints are real and verified. This helps me make smart decisions, finding a business I can trust.
The BBB, one of the highest honors a local business or organization can receive is the Better Business Bureau Award. And one of those winners was just announced, several of them actually.
Right, and one of them is with us here, Wendell Hicks, Executive Director of the Southern Arizona AIDS Foundation, who just won the 2019 Nonprofits Ethics Award, along with Director of Marketing and Outreach, Myriam Cruz. Thanks to both of you so much for being here.
Glad to be here. Congratulations.
Thank you. Job well done. Myriam, let's start with you and talk about the Torch Awards. Talk about some of the highlights.
Yes, it was an extremely inspirational night. Every year we honor our local businesses. So this year we had a new category, the Nonprofit Ethics Award. But we had six winners, three in the business ethics category, two in the nonprofit ethics category. And then we have a Spark Award that honors the millennial entrepreneur. Mm-hmm. So that was pretty exciting. We also had Adia Barnes, the head coach of the women's basketball coach at the University of Arizona. She was our keynote speaker and she did an amazing job. So these are some of our winners, the Rising Effect, Hardin Brothers Automotive, Casa de la Luz, IMU 360, SAAF, and Gavino Delgado with La Villita Landscaping in Saguarita. So a very exciting night.
Very much so, and big applause to all of them. And Wendell, this must mean a lot to you. When did you find out you were getting the award, and how did it feel?
Well, we found out we had made the finalist, and we were just thrilled about that.
Uh-huh.
I will tell you, since I was a little boy, I always looked for the blue sticker in a business, because I guess my parents told me those were the ones to trust.
Right.
And we go into one that didn't have it, and I say, why are we going in here?
You
don't have
this
the blue BBB sticker. So now it's really incredible to be a part of a wonderful organization that has that sticker in our window. Mm-hmm.
What a beautiful story. And so, of course, you know, it took a lot of work and a lot of trials to get to this point, to be recognized like this. So talk about some of the work SAAF does and what it took to get to this point.
Well, you know, SAAF has over 35 years been helping people with HIV/AIDS and preventing HIV/AIDS among hepatitis C and other things. And recently we just ended a capital campaign and we built a beautiful youth center.
Oh, really?
On 4th Avenue. It's Thornhill Lopez Center for Youth. So it's a SAAF place, but it's also all kinds of programming. We collaborate with El Rio for health checks and all kinds of other things for youth. So we've taken on that and it's grown like crazy. But what really helped was actually going through the accreditation process for us, because you learn about what things you're missing that you don't know you're missing by the BBB helping
so
us
true.
Get
right.
to those things. Mm-hmm. So just getting the accreditation itself is so beneficial for SAAF anyway, and I know other organizations it has been. But to receive the award, and to be recognized for a culture of ethics and trust and transparency, that means everything.
Absolutely.
That means everything. Donors need to know where their money's going and if the money is being used for what it's intended to.
Mm-hmm.
So as we're moving forward and being transparent and honoring that part of our culture for you
fantastic.
All to recognize that. It's really
we can just feel the passion radiating, can't we? Just the pride that you must have to have been awarded this.
And it must mean a lot to your volunteers and your staff.
And our board and our clients, because hopefully this will just help them trust us even more.
Absolutely. So Myriam, so can we start nominating people for next year's awards now?
Yes, definitely. So nominations are open and we are taking nominations in the three categories: business ethics, nonprofit, and entrepreneur. So if you know an entrepreneur that is 35 years old or younger, you can nominate them for that award. And of course we have wonderful nonprofits here in Southern Arizona, and we really encourage people to nominate those as well. If they go to BBB.org, the nomination form is live, and we'll continue taking nominations up until the end of November, and then we'll start the process of naming finalists, and then again, really selecting winners for the 2020 Torch Awards.
What an event. I mean, it has such a profound impact on not only these organizations, but the people that take advantage of your services, for example. I mean, it's already trusted, but to have, like you're saying, that blue sticker, it just adds a whole other level.
Absolutely, I want to commend our BBB for doing this, and I think they've got national recognition for pushing this forward, then including nonprofits. We're like businesses. We bring many jobs into the community. Mm-hmm. We bring money to the economy here, and hopefully we are going to help, or we continue to help our community be healthier mm-hmm. and stigma-free is what we would like.
Well, we are lucky to have both of your organizations mm-hmm. and you being a part of it.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And the BBB is having their monthly networking mixer next Tuesday on May 14th. That's from 5 to 7 p.m. at the Monterey Court. For more information, you can head over to their website. It's bbb.org, or you can call them at 520-888-5353.